Let us discuss the magnetic moment due to electron revolution in nth orbit. As we have seen that if in the surrounding of a nucleus, an electron is revolving in nth orbit, say it is of radius rn and moving with a velocity vn. Correspondingly, we consider a current In is flowing in the orbit and the value of In, we have seen that it is given as 4 pi square k square z square e to power 5 m divided by n cube h cube. And if a current is flowing in an equivalent coil of radius rn, we can directly write the magnetic dipole moment, or only magnetic moment, which can also be termed magnetic dipole moment or magnetic moment of the equivalent coil is here. This can be given as Mn, and the value is current multiplied by the area enclosed by the current, which here is pi Rn square. Now, if you substitute the value of In and Rn also, we have calculated as n square h square over 4 pi square Kze square m. I just leave it as an exercise for you to substitute the values. I am just writing down the final simplified value, which you will be getting is Enh over 4 pi m. This is the magnetic moment of nth orbit you are getting. You can see it is independent of the atomic number of the atom. It depends only on the quantum number of the orbit. And here also for n equals to 1, that is for the first orbit, if we calculate m1, it is Eh over 4 pi m. This you can see, it is a familiar term for all of you, which we call Bohr magneton. And this itself has a very important characteristic value in defining the magnetic properties of materials, which you might have studied or you will study in the section of magnetic properties.